Hey guys, welcome to this video on subtracting large numbers. I'm assuming you all know how to subtract smaller numbers, like 9 minus 2 at this point, since now you're venturing on to learn how to subtract large numbers. Well, good news. It is the exact same method. The numbers just get harder to do in your head. So learning helpful methods to help subtract large numbers will help save you some trouble. Let's look at a few different examples. We'll start smaller. Now, the first thing you need to make sure of when subtracting large numbers is that your number places are lined up correctly. For instance, in our example here, 7 and 9 are both in the ones place, so they need to be lined up directly across from one another. When you try to subtract 9 from 7, that will give you a negative number, which we can't have because we know 27 is bigger than 9. So we need to borrow from our next place value over here, which is in the tens place. So to do that, we will subtract 1 from our 2, which is going to leave us with a 1 here, and then we bring that 1 down in front of our 7 to give us 17. So now we have 9 being subtracted from 17, which gives us 8. So we'll bring our 8 down, and again, we want to keep our number place values aligned. Now we can imagine that there's a 0 here to the left of our 9. Which means that we aren't subtracting anything from the 1 that we have left over. So we can just go ahead and bring that 1 down. So that gives us 18 as our answer. We're really spaced apart 18. Let's try something a little harder. Let's take 567 and take 98 away from it. So don't forget, we need to line up our number places correctly. So we have 567. And now as I write out my 98, I need to make sure to keep my place value. So if it's 98, that's going to be in our tens place, and our 8's going to be in our 1 place. And we're subtracting, so we need that. So like in our last example, we are trying to take something bigger away than what we have here. So we need to borrow from our sweet neighbor 6 here, which means we're taking 1 away from it. So we cross out the 6. And that gives us 5 left over. And then we're going to bring down that 1 in front of our 7. Now we have 17 minus 8, which is 9. So keeping our number places aligned. So we bring that down to our ones place. Now at this point, we are only worried about everything going on in our tens place. Only subtract numbers from their corresponding place values. So now we have 5 minus 9. Since 9 is more than 5, we need to borrow from our hundreds place, so from our 5 over here. So we need to take 1 away from 5, so we'll cross that out, and that gives us 4. And we're bringing that 1 in front of our 5 here, because remember, we already borrowed 1 from the 6, and it had a 5 left over. Okay, now we have 15 minus 9, which is 6. So we need to carry that 6 down right here in our tens place, or to the left of our 9. Let's write 6 right there. So, since we aren't taking anything away from our 4 in our hundreds place here, we can just carry that 4 down, giving us our answer, which is 469. Now, for our last example, let's take a look at how to borrow across zeros. I'll show you what I mean. Let's take 3001 and take away 999 from it. So that's, remember, aligning all our place values, ones place. Subtract. Boom. So we know we can't take 9 away from our 1 here without giving us a negative number. So we need to borrow. But when we go to borrow, in our tens place, we have a 0. We have nothing to take from. And that's the same case with our hundreds place. So what ends up happening is we're taking 1 away from this 300 right here. So 1 minus 300 is 299. So we can cross this out. And we'll take the 1 that we borrowed and bring it in front of our 1 here to give us 11. So now we have 9 being subtracted from 11, which is 2. So we carry down that 2. Then when we go over to our next place, we have 9 minus 9, which is 0. And another 9 minus 9, which is 0. So we can just carry both of those two zeros down. 0 and 0. So now we're left with 2 in the thousands place, but we aren't taking anything away from it. So we can just bring that down, giving us 2002 as our answer. This borrowing works with all subtraction. Just remember to only subtract numbers from their corresponding place values and cross out and write the new number when you borrow. This will help you to follow your own work and to minimize making mistakes. I hope this helps. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel below for further help. See you next time.